Final, Jeffy, for the final. The final, everything. This is it, the big money. Who's going to go first? Who's going to start off? Somebody. We're filming this, we can't have silence, Griff.
Don't bring me down for 100.
Don't bring me down for 100, all right. Don't bring me down for 100. Depressed people often report disturbances in this vegetative behavior, which is a disturbance of a person's function necessary to maintain life. Now, there are many that we talked about, but I had one in capital letters. You mentioned?
Sleep.
Sleep is it. Wow, okay, fantastic. All right, sleep was it. You know what? I tell you what, Sean, the ball goes to you.
Don't bring me down 200.
Don't bring me down for 200. All right, okay. This will be for the 3-day trip to downtown Detroit. So, depressed individuals who receive psychotherapy are more or less likely to relapse than individuals on antidepressants alone. What do you think? Yeah.
Less likely.
Less likely to relapse. Oh, my goodness. Doing that part of the board. All right. These patients are less likely to relapse. Okay. Come on. Somebody else. Oh, my goodness. You can use your glasses to then for us training. Okay. Please pick a category.
Don't bring me down.
Don't bring me down for 300. All right. Okay. All right. Stay true or false to the following. Depression is more common in women than men. Okay. True or false?
True.
All right. In depressed people, the left hemisphere is less activated than expected. Panic. True. Okay. All right. Now, whether or not, okay, you know my objections to all these things. Okay. All right. Let's go. Okay. Somebody else. Edwin. Come on, Edwin. Edwin sells jewelry out of the back of her pickup. Come on, Edwin. What you got? Come on. Come on. Gonna go faster. I'm sorry? Nobody's crazy here for 100. All right, here we go. Nobody's crazy here for 100. Depression, which regularly occurs during the particular season, is known as blank. Sorry? Seasonal affective disorder is correct. And where does this phenomenon most often occur?
Further away.
Further away from the equator and the poles. Okay, very good. Okay, super. Here we go. Okay, those four screens. Okay, here we are. All right, come on, somebody else. Somebody else. All right. Pick something.
Nobody's crazy here at 200.
Nobody's crazy here for 200. Okay, nobody's crazy for 200. Somebody with bipolar depression alternates between what two states?
Mania and depression.
Oh, very, very good. All right, okay, all right. Natalie works as a psychic healer in a body repair shop. Come on, Natalie, give us another one.
Give me those drugs 100.
Give me those drugs for 100. Oh, I know you want them. What category of antidepressant medications work by preventing the presynaptic neuron from reabsorbing serotonin after it is released? Oh, easy question.
SSRIs.
SSRIs, too easy. All right, take another one.
All right, give me those drugs 200.
Give me those drugs. You like this category, I know. Okay, all right. SSRIs operate similarly to what other class of drugs? They have a similar mechanism. Sean?
TCAs,
tricyclics, all right. Bonus question. Which is the more effective medication of the two? Tricyclics or SSRIs? Question. Let's look for the answer. Okay, ha! Trick question. This is more effective, and imprimine the tricycle is still the gold standard. Oh, tricky. All right, very good. Okay. Somebody else, come on. Somebody else on this side of the room, come on. Somebody, Edwin, come on.
I see dinosaurs
with one hand. Okay. I remember he said it. Okay, what structural defect in the brain is often seen as schizophrenia? Today, that was today.
Yeah, no.
Short-term memory.
Enlargement.
Ventricular enlargement, okay. And is this or some other structural defect seen in the majority of cases of schizophrenia? No, okay, not according to me. I question other people who say so, that's me. And I write it. All right, anybody else? Come on, this side of the room. Come on, stay on this side of the room. Okay, please.
Memory
is for what? Memories for 100, all right. Memories for 100, memory, okay. Blank memory has limited capacity. What blank is about my memory capacity? Easy question.
Oh, brim.
Short-term memory has limited capacity. Long-term memory has unlimited capacity. Okay, something else. right, somebody else, come on, somebody else. Jesus, come on. Come on. It's dangerous, I know your names now, see?
Don't bring me down for 400.
Don't bring me down for 400. All right, 400. Okay, here you go. Becoming depressed after giving birth to a child is known as easy question. Postpartum depression. Can't make it any easier. Goodness. And I tried to. Okay, come on, Jesus, take another.
Nobody's crazy here for
300. Okay, what is Korsakoff syndrome? Anybody, Korsakoff syndrome? Just get it, approximately. John?
Wet brains, deterioration of the brain due to alcoholism?
Sure, that's it, absolutely. Chronic memory disorder caused by severe deficiency of thiamine, most commonly caused by alcohol misuse. I mean, yeah, just the concept, that's it. I'm just looking for the concept. Okay, so, second part of the question. Who is most likely to develop this syndrome?
Alcoholic.
All right, very good, very, very good. Long-term alcoholics. What is the unique symptom of the syndrome that which we discussed in class? That's question.
Made
is
up
well.
Memories.
That's question. Sorry?
Made up memories.
Yes, do you know the name of that? Who knows the name of made up memories? Who can make up a name of made up memories? Come on. Somebody. Confabulation is correct. All right. All right, here we go. All right, come on, somebody else, somebody else. Come on, come on, come on. Natalie.
Memories for 200?
Memories for 200, here we go. All right, memories for 200. Okay, this is a terrible, terrible question, but I was going with it. Whenever you watch a scary movie, you always eat chocolate-covered raisins. After a while, just seeing chocolate-covered raisins makes you scared. In this classical paradigm, classical conditioning, what is the movie? What about chocolate-covered raisins? What is the feeling of being scared? Anybody? Okay, here's the question you asked. Did you have to learn or be conditioned to feel scared?
No.
The movie made you scared, right? So, no conditioning, no learning, right? Unconditioned stimulus, unconditioned response. Raisins, however, are you normally, were you originally scared of raisins?
No.
that's raisin phobia. Okay. Right, so the raisins, right, they become your conditioned stimulus, right? This is the one you have to learn, right? Okay. Very good. All right, unconditioned stimulus. Okay, oops. Okay, let's another one. Time is running short. Somebody.
I see dinosaurs
for 200. Okay. All right. In schizophrenia, an example of a positive symptom would be blunt, while an example of a negative symptom would be blunt. Pick one. Positive symptom? Hallucinations, more delusions. Example negative symptom?
Flat affect,
goodness me. Social isolation, anhedonia, and more. Okay, very, very good. All right, okay. About halfway through, let's keep going. We gotta keep going. Chunk.
Give me drugs for 300.
Okay, my favorite saying. All right. Name the four major categories of antidepressants as discussed in class. Okay, not the only way to mention. Chunk.
SSRIs.
SSRI.
MAOIs. TCAs.
Sean, would you describe me as typical?
Atypical.
Thank you. Okay. Very good. You're all correct. Heard it many times. Okay, all right, let's keep going. Okay, Julie, you are here. I'd like you to participate. Pick a category. Sorry? What's the category?
Give me those drugs for
400, all right. Before the advances of more recent work in psychopharmacology, how were many medications or drugs discovered?
Trying them out.
Trial and error, accident, whatever. People went home, took them, you know, had a good time, partying, okay. What else? All right, come on, somebody else. Come on. Hope?
Nobody's crazy for
400, all right. What drug is commonly prescribed for bipolar disorder? Lithium, okay. Why should we be very careful to monitor its levels in the blood?
Too much of it is toxic,
I'm sorry?
Too much high levels of it. If you're right, it becomes toxic.
Right. It has a narrow therapeutic window, right? And so you go, if it goes too far, it starts to become toxic.
Okay, very good, very good.
Okay, so why don't you take another one? Okay. Come on.
Nobody's crazy for 500.
Okay. Nobody's crazy here. All right. Okay. What is the most common side effect for ECT or the most therapy? Memory loss is the most common complaint. Very good. All right. Okay, let's see. Come on, Victoria, you don't know this, but she's actually an authority on shredded cheese. Come on, Victoria, give us a category.
Memories for 300.
Sorry?
Memories
for, memories for 300. Forgetting memories prior to brain injury is blank amnesia, while being unable to form new memories after brain injury is blank amnesia. Sean?
Retrograde and cerebral.
And anterior, very good. Retrograde and anterior, super. All right, come on. Somebody over here, come on. Somebody from this side of the room. Make a call on you. Ashley? Take a category. I'm sorry?
I see dinosaurs
for 300. All right, here we go. What is the concordance ratio for monozygotic identical twins with schizophrenia?
50%.
About 50%, right? Okay, now, what are some of the causes of schizophrenia as discussed in class?
Viral.
Genetic. Dopamine. Glutamate, right? Okay. So, genetics, environment, viral hypothesis, migration of neurons in the hippocampus, toxins, drugs, shoe size, on your dog, orange juice, pretty much whatever you want. Okay, we have a theory for anyone who wants one. Okay, come on, we're coming close to the end. Let's finish this up.
Memories 400.
Oh, I'm sorry?
Memories 400.
Memories for 400. Very good. Memories for 400. Okay. The ability to save memory words is known as blank memory, while the ability to perform a certain skill or test is known as blank memory. Sean?
Declarative and procedural.
Declarative and procedural. Word. All right, man. You're going to have a hard time catching up. Declarative and procedural. Okay, Sean, take another one.
Don't bring me down to 500.
Don't bring me down to 500. All right, bonus questions. If medications for depression begin exerting effects soon after the patient takes the medication, why does it take weeks or months to see an effect on mood and behavior?
Genes. Genetics.
I'm sorry?
Genetics.
You know, that is actually part of the question. I just want to hear it more fully. That is true.
Oh.
Well, how so? How are genetics part of this? How do you mean that? Okay, that's right. Right. It's just right. You know, but you're giving me Morse code answers, you know, it's a full sentence, you know what I'm saying? Did you think I was just gonna give you the answer? Of course not. Let's see. But again, changes have to be made by intercellular and intracellular mechanisms, which will involve genes and the proteins they produce and all this casting, right? So that takes time, right? Okay. Right? Let's see, we're almost done. We've got two more categories. Let's finish this out. Okay, let's finish this out.
I see dinosaurs for 400,
okay. All right. A single gene has been identified that accounts for all cases of schizophrenia. True or false?
False.
Ridiculous. Childhood schizophrenia is considered common. True or false?
Very
easy questions. Come on, almost done. Four more questions. All right, who's going to help me out?
Is that
razors? Drugs? Come on, drugs. Okay. What is the mechanism of action of most antipsychotic medication? That we just really went over today. The blocking of
dopamine.
Okay, there are other things going on in some of the new antipsychotics, you know, block serotonin, etc. But this is still the principal way that these mechanisms work. Okay, these drugs. Okay. Three more.
I see dinosaurs for 500.
All right. I see dinosaurs for 500. In making a differential diagnosis of schizophrenia, what is essential for you to do? You're going to rule out everything else that it could. You're going to rule out all the other organic symptoms. All the other organic syndromes, dementia, epilepsy, everything like that, and make sure that you're really looking at what you consider to be schizophrenia. Okay. Two more questions, come on. Memories, last one in memories. Who's going to take this one? Sean's going to take memories, all right. Okay. And here we go. Carl Ashley looked for a physical basis of memory, what she called a blank. It also stated two principles known as blank and blank. Sean. Okay, n-gram. Okay. Natalie has n-gram. That's the first answer.
Mass action equal potentiation.
Equal potentiality and mass action. Absolutely. So the n-gram, that was what he called the physical basis of memory. And his laws, his principles were equal potentiality and mass action, which I will ask him about. Okay, so that leaves us.
We're
done. Nothing. Oh, no. By stimulating the blank receptor and then expels the blank ion out of the blank receptor site, which allows blank and blank ions to enter the blank receptor. Ultimately, the single cascade ends in the nucleus where new blanks are created. Wow. That's why this is the Jeopardy question. All right, let's start it out. First one. Take it one at a time. The long-term potential is used by stimulating what receptor?
The AMPA.
The AMPA receptor, correct. And you expel the blank ion, what ion gets expelled?
Magnesium.
Out of the
NMDA.
NMDA site. Oh, now you're just moving along. Which allows blank and blank ions, what ions are entering?
Sodium and calcium.
Sodium and calcium, oh my goodness. And enters the, what receptor?
Is it
sodium? I realize more. We're looking more for the NMDA for that calcium,
okay?
Right, ultimately the single cascades in the nucleus where? Right, proteins. Okay, very good. Why should I tell you? Come on. Well, amp, magnesium, NMDA, calcium, sodium, NMDA, very good. All right, super. All right, you did an excellent job.